About the first thing that struck me in flying model aircraft was their variety. I like gliders myself. The experts say you should start with gliders to learn about flying. And with a model this size, it's not so simple. Picking the moment to let go, for instance. That's about it. And you've got to move quickly. Once she's in a thermal, she can go for miles. That's true of rubber-powered models as well. But they're popular jobs. Some aero modelers won't fly anything else. Introduce all sorts of refinements, like self-feathering props and lubricants to make the strands wind evenly. What they can't do is to bring the plane back to them. And that's where radio control comes in. If she's handled properly, your plane banks or turns just as you want. The secret is to keep your eye on her. Even then, landing's a problem if the wind's strong, but you can save yourself a lot of chasing with control like this. The transmitter sends out a signal to the receiver in the fuselage, and the receiver flicks over the rudder. Of course, radio control's not everyone's choice. Some people are more interested in construction, building their own ideas or scale models from Lancasters to the old biplanes. Others concentrate on the engines. Pulse jets are the newest. They're fast as well as loud, 120 miles an hour or so. But most aero modelers still use piston engines. Spark ignition, or glow plug, or diesel. Claim they're more reliable, especially on starting. Remember, you've only got one cylinder, and 6cc is a big one. When you get down to half cc, which wouldn't hold a pea, diesels are most used. Which is best is a matter of opinion. Diesel fans claim their engines are sure starters, with a device to change cylinder capacity. Sweeter running. Anyway, they're much simpler. No batteries to run flat at awkward moments. Others swear by sparking plugs. If you keep the points clean so as to get a good fat spark. There's one drawback. Your model needs batteries, coil and wiring, and that sends the weight up. You use spark engines for free flying. A cutoff on the fuel supply gives a short engine run. Then a stable plane will glide. With every model, you must watch the weight. And that's where the glow plug engine scores. Like the diesel, there's no wiring to go wrong. You need a battery for starting only, to heat the filament inside the plug. Once the engine's going, it keeps hot on its own. To get a long power flight with these planes, you fly on a line of piano wire. You couldn't let this vampire run wild. In fact, you have two lines to control the elevator and give you a grip on your plane. That's pretty good. but it's at one of the big meetings you get real variety. Aero modelers from miles around taking part in the competitions or just showing off their pet ideas.
Good afternoon, everybody, and good flying, if you can beat this wind. Competitors, please check in here before test flying. Competitors, report here, please.
You can toss your plane about on control lines, so long as you don't turn your lines into a piece of knitting. That's a new thing. You have three pilots in the middle with mechanics standing by outside the circuit to refuel. If you get tangled up with another plane, you're out. They're racing over a 10-mile circuit. That means at least two pit stops for more fuel. Time this one. Seconds. That's where teamwork counts. Even if you're playing slower in the air, and most of them will do more than 70 miles an hour. That's one time you'd like less fuel in your tank. You can't land with the engine running. Still, it takes more than that to damp real enthusiasts who need patience. Patience. And even more, determination.